Wonderful guys, we're going to think about how to prepare for CAT 2021. Wonderful, happy new year to all of you. It's a wonderful time to be starting off on new projects. Just a wonderful new project. So I'm going to break this whole thing into two parts. What should you be doing and what kind of mental makeup is required to be doing that? And so preparation phase neatly breaks into three parts. One is the learning fundamental, that is consolidating and practice. Third is doing a bunch of mocks and getting exam ready. First part, which probably runs for 6 months, is going to be focused on learning from fundamentals. So learn basics, learn that average of two numbers is a plus b by 2. Figure out why a certain system of equation has a unique solution, why some do not. Figure out why root of a quadratic equation is minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. What is the proof for the idea that sum of two sides of a triangle is greater than the third one? What is the meaning of subject-verb agreement? That kind of stuff. Learn with detail. Don't worry about speed. Don't worry about doing things dramatically quickly. Don't worry about reading speed, any of that. Learn for the idea of learning that topic. Don't be continuously consumed by what is a CAT level question, how many questions from CAT will come. Learn inequalities, learn percentages, learn geometry, learn parajumble. Learn the idea of solving one type of logical reasoning puzzles. So that's a big focus area. That will be the main part of building the base, on top of which everything else will be layered on top. This goes on throughout, but it will be more predominant in the first 5-6 months. Then comes the middle chunk, which is the heavy duty drill and practice thing. Right? So your mind has to automate a bunch of processes, right? Which is very crucial because it's a competitive exam. And so if you're saying the wealth is being divided in the ratio 2:3, total amount of wealth present is 25. Some people automatically think of it as 10 and 15. Others have to write it as 2:3, adding up to 5. If this were 25, what does it become? The more drill you put in, the more automatic some of these nice simple nuggets become, which help twofold. One is in building speed, other is in giving you the stamina. So the guys who really get this exam, switch off and on. The routine processes, they just do. Only the trickier bits they have to process so they don't get tired. So it's a double whammy and it's a massive advantage. The best parallel I can think of is learning to ride a bike or learning to ride a car, learning to drive a car. If you're learning to drive a car, the first few days, you move bit by bit, your mind is continuously processing, okay, I need to press the clutch now, I need to hold the gear out, I need to release the clutch, I need to accelerate at the same time, think about where I'm driving. You're doing 5 things. But if you've done 300 kilometers, your mind moves automatically. You can have a conversation with somebody, listen to music and drive at the same time. Your mind is the same machinery, but it can parallelly do 2-3 things because that one thing is heavily automated. So you need to do the drill in order to build speed, build stamina, build intensity so that you can amp up the next thing. This takes about again 4 to 5 months, but you can't finish process one and start process two. You learn from fundamentals for 2-3 months, start doing the drill so that you consolidate ideas better and better. And then you keep learning fundamentals and adding more layers to the drill. And the final lap is mocks. You have to plan to take around about 25 mocks. You should take it from multiple providers, multiple styles at multiple times with multiple strategies. So you need to give yourself the freedom to tweak and fine tune. So you create an engine. And then finally, before you get race ready, you change a variable here, change a variable there, get some straight time speed, find some variance so that you can amp up and get that final 25-30%. From your first mock to last mock, your score will more than double. And you'll find each of those wins by thinking about the big picture, thinking about how am I going to strategize for a 3-hour or a 2-hour paper? Where are my marks coming from? What kind of questions am I leaving? All of that. Don't put that process and evaluation on day one. Right. So 3 phases of preparation. First is for building fundamentals. Second is for getting comfort level and building speed. Third one is for taking mocks and seeing where you stand. And so obviously there'll be an overlap between 1 and 2, 2 and 3. There'll be an overlap between 1 and 3. You'll continue to learn from basics a week before your exam. Fine. And when you're doing practice, you'll see where you stand. You'll start taking mocks by April. So, but predominantly the first half, the first chunk learning from fundamentals happens in the first few months. Assessment and mocks happen in the last few months, right? So keep that in mind as a framework for preparing for everything. On top of this, what you must definitely do is to read. You should look to read for at least 1 hour every day. We're going to discuss on what to read, how to read, when to read, all of that in a separate video. So do look at that, do read that. But reading for an hour or so on a daily basis. It's a habit that's built over months. So start that today if you don't already have the habit. And so what else do you focus on? What is the plan overall? As far as the theoretical framework is concerned, there is a heavier quant bias. So in your initial month, you'll be doing more and more math. That's understandable. But at some point of time, you switch out and say, I'm going to think about the big picture. I understand that the paper is one third roughly. So keep that in mind. But initial phase will be dominated by quant. That quant base is going to give you some comfort level for the LRDA section. The reading comfort is going to anchor your VARC. So there's going to be a quant bias as far as fundamentals are concerned. That's inevitable, understandable, and good. At some point of time, you'll switch out and say, okay, this is the bias I'm going to. In terms of number of hours, how much should you devote? The first 5-6 months, you're looking to do 10 to 12 hours per week. And then you're saying, okay, I'm picking it up to 15, 18. The last few weeks or last month or so, you're looking to do 30 hours per week. Now, this is not an astronomically high amount, but it is very, very, very crucial that the 10 hours you put or 12 hours you put are a complete 10, 12 hours, not distracted with my mobile, checking my Instagram 10 hours. There are two different things. Fine, so you allot 10 hours for CAT prep every week, carve it out. Remember, this is a marathon, not a sprint. You can't suddenly have a 25-hour boost and have 3 weeks of nothing coming from there. But 10 hours carving out of your week, every week, week on week, you commit to that. Take my word for it, you'll definitely go places in that. And so, but how you carve out that 10 hours, that freedom is up to you. Suppose you have a very tight work week, you can't do anything from Monday to Friday, carve it out on Saturday and Sunday. Or you're the kind of person who wakes up early and you can do an hour and a half early morning every day, go for that option. Fine, so, but 10 hours a week is not astronomically high. It is very doable and you should squeeze that in if you want to give this a serious shot. When you go to the second, third phase, then you'll amp it up. You will have to find some time squeezed out from somewhere else. We'll come to that part later on. Now, temperamentally, what you should be doing, you're signing up for a long journey. You're signing up for a learning journey. Keep that in mind. You must plan very diligently to learn with discipline and fun. It seems like they're opposing things. They're not. You need to be disciplined about the number of hours you put in, how well you plan and execute that. You should have fun in the joy, have joy in the act of learning what you do. That is very crucial. If you don't do that, the pressure will slowly start getting to you. From day one, look to enjoy the process of learning and moving different pieces for this exam. Don't have a heavy duty final target in mind and keep that as a driver. Some part of the motivation should be intrinsic. You've got to say, okay, I'm going to understand percentages and profit and loss really well. I'm going to have a lot of fun solving these questions. We'll see where it takes me. It cannot always be, I need to get 98th percentile, crack this interview, go to that place, get the package. It doesn't work like that. It becomes dispiriting then if you have a couple of setbacks in mocks. Keep that in mind. Second thing, you have to have tons of belief. And you're all preparing for this exam for a long stretch of time. It's an exam with clearly uncertain outcomes. On the day of the exam, stuff can happen. A week before, something else can happen. The scores can go your way, but the result might not, or the final admit might not. Things can happen. So you cannot be heavily contingent on investing heavily in one outcome. It doesn't always play out like that. Enjoy the process, learn tons of stuff. Measure input variables very aggressively. How much have I learned? How many hours did I do this? How many questions did I solve? How many books did I read? How many long articles have I read? Those are all wonderful metrics to chase. Am I at 94th percentile level? Is an answer you can't get in concrete form, nor is it that meaningful very early on. So once you get the hang of this game, the last lap, you can have a realistic expectation of where you're headed and how you should plan, how you should tweak. But don't be completely motivated by that from day one. Have a mechanism where you definitely enjoy the process of learning ideas. That is absolutely crucial. And have tons of belief. You tell yourself, I'm going to throw everything into this, enjoy this process, and give myself a great shot. If things fall my way, they do. If they don't, I still have tons of things looking forward to. Fine. Wonderful, guys. Happy learning. Once again, a wonderful happy new year to you, and best wishes for your preparation.